Hello everyone, and welcome back to All of Fabric 6. I'm just now realizing, I don't know if I called it All of Fabric in the last episode. I may have said all the mods. I'm not sure. Listen, when you have this many episodes, it gets a bit confusing. We're once again checking out bases. In the last episode, we checked over Afghanistan and this base over here, Shihaba. And already, this island over here that we looked at, I'll just have a quick jump in over here. It has improved since, and I checked it out, probably a few hours ago, so there's been a lot, there's quite a lot going on here, so I'm very excited to check this out in longer than a few hours, you know what I mean? But yeah, it's looking really cool, so props to you. This episode, we're probably going to look at quite a few more smaller bases. We've got Khifu's base over here. Where are we? Yeah, here it is. So there's a nice little farm, and what I stumbled upon this base, like, just literally seconds ago. I was like, oh, I'll see what this one is. And I really like it, because this type of design is exactly my type of design, where it's like, okay, look, this could all just be wooden planks, but Khifu's clearly gone, you know what? We're gonna spice things up. we'll add a trim of cobblestone. And look, it looks better. It looks substantially better than it would if it was just oak planks, but it's still, you know, it's nothing to write home about. And I think the same happened with this farmer. It's like, you know what? I'll put some oak planks around it, you know, really spice things up. And, oh, in the middle, a 2x2 infinite water source instead of just the traditional one block. And I'll tell you what, it works. It looks nice. So we've also got some Certus Quartz blocks. What do we have? Some sugarcane. We actually have a steam engine, which I don't even have. I don't even know what it's being used for, but it's got some blaze burners under there to generate the heat needed. The water's being provided from a pump, so nothing too crazy. Arguably, looking here, not enough water, but it's there. It's trying. It's doing its thing. And I'm not sure what it's going to be for, because there's not really any create stuff over here, but I guess the foundation's there. We've got a bunch of machines. What it could have been is like, oh, you know what? I'll start making this, and then you get to a point where you're like, oh, actually, that's too much effort. Okay, I'll start doing this, and you're like, actually, I need some steel. So then you're like, oh, I'll start doing this, and then that's sort of what I'm doing at the moment, just jumping around. We've got Modmus's player head everywhere, and I mean, that's seemingly the base. We've got a coffin, some iron chest. I wonder if the coffin lets you skip daytime into nighttime. That would make sense. It might be like the what do they call it? The hammock from Nails, Tough as Nails, or whatever the mod was from the older mods packs. Anyhow, that appears to be everything. We can check out the nether portal without going in, thanks to Immersive Cursedness. It should be linked. And so as we can see, it doesn't really look like there's any build on the other side of the portal, so we don't really have to jump in. Although, the structure around it does appear dome-ish, you know what I mean? Like, I don't think so, though. I think it's just a coincidence. There is also this tunnel. I'll look down at this level here that's lit up, but I don't think there's anything crazy going on down here. No, it looks like it's just another mine. So, that's Khifu's base. Thank you for taking the time to build the base. Let's jump over to Thesdro's base. Ooh, a bit of a change of scenery. I think we've had a lot of mountains and whatnot and ocean over here, whereas, I mean, it's the same, like, description, but I guess no mountains, and I don't know, it feels a lot different than what we've been seeing. So we've got some fire. I never know if it's pronounced brazier or brazier. I think it's brazier, right? That sounds more rocky, whereas the other one sounds more clothy, right? I think so. And these actually have some leaves on them. I'm not sure. I don't even know what you'd call it. Is this a little pot plant, or is this a tree, or is it, like, I don't know what it's meant to be, but it's doing it, you know. It looks nice. I love that there's two doors. Is one of these an indoor and the other an outdoor? That is amazing. Listen, another thing I love about doing these videos, no two bases are the same. Even when it comes down to just the doors, like, what is this? When was the last time, if ever, that you guys made a base with an indoor and an outdoor? You didn't do it. On top of that, they're oak doors, you know? Like, you could have just placed the pressure plate on the other side. But I guess the benefit is that when you walk through, it closes a bit faster. Whereas when you walk through this one, if you had another one there, it, like, clicks again. You know what I mean? You guys, anyway, I don't know. I'm trying to justify it. Anyway, this is filled up with a bunch of machines. We've got wine bottles, aging barrels, and apple presses, all from Vinery. I don't know the point. I don't understand the point of the wine. What, like, does it give you potion effects? Oh, it does. Okay, so you get like night vision, you get jump boost and stuff, teleports and whatnot. Okay, that's pretty cool. My guess as well is that as it ages with more years, perhaps it gets more duration for the potion effect, maybe more hunger and whatnot, but that does sound pretty cool, especially since the server has like chunk loading and it's on 24/7. You could probably set up a night vision bottle, leave it in here, and it'll age like crazy compared to what the mod is probably intending for it to age like. That actually sounds incredible. Because what we could do then is I could have the night vision. Like, we actually should look into that. I might bookmark the night vision potion if I can find out which one it was again. Because if we can just use night vision things, like, you know, I play once a day, let's say for 2 hours max. Surely we can get a bottle where I can just drink that. We've got night vision for the day. And then I just can wear the different backpacks we have. These, like, blaze backpacks for fall damage or the lapis for experience. Like, I think that's a pretty good option. So, yeah, that's cool. We'll have to check out Vinery at some point. The rest looks to just be storage, some basic storage units, just a bunch of basic stuff. Iron alloys, iron furnaces. Nothing too crazy. A little wooden crank on top of the charger. Haven't seen that yet this series, so that's pretty nice. And that's all she wrote. All right, let's head on out. Over here we have what I assume would be a farm. I will say, this is just the design is really nice. Like, the building as itself is kind of like, meh. But then this on the side of it, I think, I don't know, it looks really, for some reason it looks really nice. The glass panes and just, this part's a bit weird. But I appreciate the effort, you know, and a bit of effort has been put to try and do something here. But I do like the dark oak and the glass pane. This whole like little area for whatever it's going to be, whether it's Certus Quartz Farming or, I like that. Like a little greenhouse essentially, just slapped on the side. Really nice. I'm talking it up a lot, but I don't know, something about it I really like. We've got a path down there, and it doesn't look like there's any big structure in the Nether, so we don't have to go in. So that's pretty convenient. Nice little base. They've clearly got some islands here that they can expand upon. Oh, probably because they've got this they've got this dungeon as well. Oh, hey, buddy. I've never seen this dungeon. That's pretty cool. All right. Well, anyway, that's there. I assume it's a dungeon. If you've built this, please do let me know, because that would be incredible. And it would be very disappointing to miss. So that is Thesdra's base. So thank you for that. Thank you for taking the time to build it. And it's looking nice. Oh, I almost missed this. A little solar generator on the side. Nice. Was that a staircase as well? Did we look down this? It looks like it's just a mine. I could be wrong, but we ain't gonna risk it. Okay, so where's next? I don't think I've looked at Shadow Wolf space. We'll jump over here, see if it looks familiar. It does not. Oh, the beanstalk. Yeah, we've seen this in the distance when we've been exploring in the actual playthrough. But we haven't actually, you know, stopped by and looked properly. So this is Shadow Wolf space, Shadow Wolf Fury. And there's a few little islands. All right. So what's going on here? Oh, this is... Okay. So this is a contraption, a sort of elevator, sort of. There's some mechanical drills on the bottom. And depending on how you want to do it, you can put a hand crank here or some sort of rotational energy. And it'll actually push this thing down. And it'll fill up these chests with goodies that it mines as the drills contact with stuff. So as you can see, there's a bunch of things here. Then when you're done or you think it might be full or whatever, you can pull it back up by just spinning it in the opposite direction. And I'll be honest, listen, if you know what you're doing and you can just slap one up, put one together, probably the best way to get early ores in the mod pack, genuinely, using create. My problem is I struggle with it. I struggle with setting them up. I really need to just make one that works reliably and works efficiently, and then get familiar with it. Because most other things with Create, I sort of know how to do now, but getting the mining stuff set up, like I could do this, right? Send it down, it gets ores. But then I've got to rebuild it somewhere else, and it's not the biggest deal, but it's just like, I'd rather not do that. And I can't be bothered doing it to begin with. So that's my little excuse there. Over here we have Spectrum. These are multi-blocks for the Spectrum mod. We've clearly got a few. What was that in the ocean? Is that just squids? All right. So these are all just Spectrum multi-blocks. I haven't touched Spectrum at all at the moment, but a lot of the features of the mod that we've seen in the roughly enough items on the side here. They look pretty good. Like, apparently there's ways to take enchantments off of things and, you know, put them into books. So you can take mending off of your golden shovel or something, for instance. And there's a bunch of other stuff similar to that. So then I imagine this is the building. I almost want to say that it's not player built because it's just so uniform. It's built with purpose. You know what I mean? Like, it's there. But regardless of whether it's player built or not, it looks to be player... what's the right word? Modified, at least. So, regardless, it's definitely taken on its own shape. And in terms of compact bases, Forash has some competition, it looks like. Forash's base, we went to his claim, and I'm like, I don't know where his base is. There was... I don't even know if it was a 1x1 hole, or if it was even smaller and we had to shrink down to the size of like a pixel of a block. Forash's base was incredibly small. So, and it was just a casual little hole in the side of a mountain. So listen, he might still have the cake, but since you can't really shrink down in this mod pack, as far as I can tell. Actually, no, I think you can. Yeah, we already had a small person trolling us a little bit, didn't we? But this is very compact. And then here's the top floor with a pet mimic, I imagine. Yep, friendly mimic. Beds, armors. Yeah, okay. Nice. It's cozy, to say the least. This is the type of base I have whenever I play, like, RLCraft just RLCraft. So next up, aside from, I mean, what, we have a coke oven down there. Not too much else. This beanstalk goes up. I mean, we have to look at the top. I can press T to teleport to the top, or at least near the top. I'm assuming I'm going to teleport if I go up here. Should I do it anyway? See if something happens? These are ruins. Ruins from Spectrum. I don't know then. I don't know. I thought there'd be maybe something at the top, but if it existed, it no longer does. So that's the base. All right, beautiful. We're about, what, 12 minutes in? We'll check another base. There is another portal. I'll have a quick look. Oh, there's some slimes over here. If you're looking for slimes, here's your biome. There you go. We may even benefit from that in our series. Oh, we've got some nether portals in there. It doesn't... Okay, so I wasn't sure what it would do, but it doesn't load the nether portal within the nether portal to show me what's on the other end. That would have been nice, but it does not do that, sadly. All right, well, thank you for building the base and spending the time on the server. These bases, they look like... It looks like we've got a collection here, you know what I mean? So that'll probably be a different episode. Should we jump into an adventurer's base? Who else do we have? Let's do it, or otherwise I'll think that I did, maybe. I don't know. Oh, my smack bang in the middle. I hope it's not massive. Okay, here we go. Oh, yeah, nice. Oh, very cool. Okay. Okay, oh, yeah, right next to a meteorite. Right in the middle of just an ice biome, it looks like. Some beautiful forests in the surrounding, and they're just sort of in this nice cleared out area in the middle. Which honestly looks very nice. So what do we have? More Spectrum stuff. We have a hole here that... Ooh. Hints to an underground contraption. Oh yeah, that enters over here. I just want to double check they haven't like refurbished this, right? Like, is this an actual base? Oh, it leads to an actual base regardless of whether it has all been fixed up. Let's hop into Spectator and just hop through the floor here. Is the rest of this just normal? It's hard to tell. I don't know if the normal one has... I think this is the normal one. I don't think they've decorated. Right? I'm not seeing any machines or anything down here. There's a big room out there, but I think that's natural as well. Maybe. Actually, I think... It's hard to tell. Let's get back to the top and see if there's... Is there a different way in? Yeah, okay. So here's the actual way that you're meant to go in. We'll check that out in a second. I'll look at everything else before that. Which, I guess there's not too much. This furnace... Oh, yeah. For some reason, I thought it was a 2x2 or a 4x4. It looked a little bit bigger. Everyone seems to have a NASA workbench. I think everyone's like, I want to go to space. But then they look at the rest of the ingredients. I haven't even bothered looking. But I'm pretty sure it's not that easy. But everyone has one of these workbenches. They do look really cool. So, like, I completely understand the allure to making them. But I don't think they're easy to get. Over here, we have that same keystone. I think you may remember if you watched the last Checking Out Base video. Where were we? Over in Afghanistan, this... thing on the top was their arena, and so clearly someone's put a little bit more effort into actually making it look like an arena, right? Little entrance, no escape. And these flames, I believe, mark the range. So if you place a block within here, it like lights up red. And that's the range that it needs. All right, what else do we have? I think that's pretty much everything above ground. We've got a nice little farm. Not too big, but yeah, big enough, I guess. A little bit of loot fabrication happening over there. All right, let's go in. So there is an elevator if you don't want to use the ladders. The elevator only goes so far, though, before you have to go down to another level. And this does look like the bottom level. So we'll check this one. This is the middle floor, I guess. Massive smelting wall. We've seen that a few times. An alchemist table for villagers plus. It looks nice, regardless of whether it's actually intentional or practical, I guess. We've got some goat skulls. Okay, so this looks like it either is a villager room. I don't see a villager in there, but it's at the very least going to be. You know what I mean? There's definitely some room. So this is where we were entering before. Over here we have not a nether portal, but... Oh, yeah, there we go. Nether portal. Oh, and a little bit of structure. Okay. We'll probably go in. Enchanting room. Let's hop through. Hopefully it doesn't take too long to load. Sometimes it loads instantly. Oh, nice. Other times it takes a little bit longer. So we do have, you know, some protection being built around here, which is very nice. That's pretty good. Goes all the way around here. Nice. Yeah. Nice and cozy. And then we can hop back in. I love that mod. Honestly. It's so upsetting that immersive portals, like actually immersive portals, don't work, because it would have been so nice to just seamlessly walk through those portals. And even set up custom portals. Oh, so nice. Apparently it's incompatible, but... Oh, I mean, here's the thing. It's incompatible, but this is so... This feels like it's right around the corner. You know what I mean? It's like, surely this works. I feel like the stuff that this does is the part that like would break normally with most other mods. So it's almost like... I think this mod... would have to adapt to it, because immersive portals, what they do is completely different, I'm pretty sure. Like, this is putting fake blocks there, immersive portals puts the real blocks. I wonder if there was a way to bring the seamless teleport to this as well. So we keep using the fake blocks, right, that this one does, so you can sort of run past and see that the nether is actually on the overworld. But if they somehow add the seamless teleport too, so maybe I can't interact with the block there or whatever, even though I think you can. But if I could just walk through and it was seamless, and then I turn around and it makes more fake blocks, that would be cool. I don't know if that's the part that's impossible as things currently are, but, you know. I'm sure that's what they're trying to do, but I don't know. I like to say it. All right, what was this room? Oh, more storage. Looks like potentially mass storage is going to go in here. This is a bit of a labyrinth. And then we've got another storage in here. Is this like... Okay, so we've got the power room, I guess. And then this room is like, yeah, just general storage. We've obviously got the villager trading room here. Enchanting room. Yeah, okay. And I believe we do have another direction. We obviously have down. This part just goes... Yeah, this is just a mine, it looks like. So spring back up. We can go back to the elevator. And we can head down another floor. So here we are. And this has more villagers. Okay, we've got a dragon egg. We've got some stuff happening, some trophies. A little bit of ores. It's a nice field down here. And then we've got a panel facing the wall. It's meant to go the other way, but, you know, it's there. It's doing its thing. What else do we have? Oh, okay. Matter condenser, a blackstone brick waystone. That looks insane. Pistons, prison torches. They look very cool. And yeah, just a little bit of everything. And then we've got our applied energistic system that... I don't know... It gets power, I guess, from a vibration chamber, which is, I guess, a coal generator for applied energistics. There you go. Beautiful. And I believe that is the base. I'll check. There was no other floor. We can jump back up. Back to the top. And that is Adventurer 89's base. So, thank you for building the base. Hopefully, you've been enjoying your time on the server, as with everyone else who has visited today. I feel like these bases we might check in the next episode. I'm not too sure. I do have a channel in Discord where you can post your base coordinates and so I can have come over look at them. I feel bad saying that though, because then people do it, right? And then I feel bad if I don't make the video. And like, we've got people from, previous mod packs and previous servers that we've had who like have their base to get checked out. And it's like, you know what I mean? Like, it's like, I feel bad not doing them. But I'll tell you what, if I ever get around to doing it, that's the list, like, that takes priority sort of thing. Or if it doesn't take priority, it's at least, like, I'm aware of it. It's obvious. Whereas if you've got a base, you know, over here, this tiny little square here. You know what I mean? Like, chances are I won't stumble upon it accidentally. It's just sort of chance-based. So if you want to increase those chances, that's probably a better way to put it. If you want to increase the chance of it getting checked out, you can post it in the Discord. But regardless, thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Watching the video and liking, subscribing, commenting, all of that stuff helps my channel grow. So thank you guys for doing that so far. Is this a natural thing? Oh yeah, looks like a ruins. But yeah, genuinely, thank you for helping grow the channel. It allows us to make videos like this because we have a community that plays on the servers and whatnot. So thank you for doing that. Thank you to our donators. Don't feel pressured to donate. Watching the video is more than enough. So thank you for doing that. But thank you to our channel members and our tier 3 channel members, Melizzy and Andre. And I may as well, you know, because might as well. We can come over here back to Melizzy's base. It's literally been 2 hours since the last episode, and I'm coming back here like, oh, what's changed? I don't think they've even been online, but I'm here. I'm looking. I'm looking for it. Nothing has changed since the last episode. What honestly probably has changed would be over here in Afghanistan, possibly, because I think they were online. And I think they were working on this. So something may have even changed since I came here 2 seconds ago. Because, yeah, see, they are flying around. So, you know, it's happening. It's happening. But, yeah, thank you guys. And hopefully I'll see you guys in the next one. Goodbye.